when anything, when the particular thing is what updated at last. For example, suppose we have to search some of the tender at mahatenders.gov.in site, and we have to identify when the last thing was updated. We can use this last updated. Okay, then we can able to search the reliable sources. For example, we can mention the name of site, like it should end at what .gov.in, so that we will identify that these are the sources that we can use. Apart from that, we can even use what certain parts. For example, if you observe here a search bar where we can able to identify any sort of formats. Normally we identify PowerPoint presentations, we identify PDF and so many documents. So all these kind of operators can be used with what Google search. Now this is the list of operator which is in front of you, and you can use this many operators to work out with what Google. So we'll see one by one, and I'll show you the importance of these operators. So let's look at what hands-on session, and for that I need to log into what google.com. So before I start with the session, I would like to tell you that if you hunt on what Mahesh Sanghvi on Google, you will get what one of the link, that is what my blog. If you open that blog, you will get what the so many menus here, and out of which you have to use the menu like expert talk. And in this expert talk menu, you can go to 1920 expert talk, and you will get what the today's presentation, as well as what notes of this today's session. So you can see here presentation which is available here, and the notes that we will discuss today will be available here. So don't worry, entire material is available here, and I have shared it freely on what this particular site. Okay, so this is all about what, how you can able to get the information or presentation of today's session. Okay, so let's log into what Google, and now we all are aware that when we go to what google.com, this particular information will be in front of us. Okay, so when this information will be in front of us, you can understand very well that, okay, here you can able to search some information. For example, my name is Mahesh Sanghvi. So I'm mentioning here Mahesh Sanghvi. When I enter this, you will understand that this many results are in front of me. Means when I search my name, Mahesh Sanghvi, it search and it is giving me results like 383,000. And then I need to search where exactly my name is available. So whatever first link which is available in front of you is my blog. Okay. And here, if I have to search, this way searching can be done. Okay. But I want exact search. So what I'm doing, I'm using the operator, that is what double quotation mark. So when I enter Mahesh Sanghvi into double quotation mark, and when I press enter, you can observe the results which are now reduced. Earlier results were in lakhs, and now it is reduced to what 8,010. And this way we can make our search effective. So you can observe here Mahesh and then what Sanghvi. And if I again mark, suppose Mahesh Ranglal G. Sanghvi, suppose my full name, I'm entering that. The moment I'm entering that, now the result is again reduced to what 4. And this way we can use what double quotation, okay, to search anything. The beauty of this double quotation is that, suppose for example, I am interested in what searching certain information. For example, you can observe here, okay, you can observe here, these are the notes that I have given, where we can mention the string into what double quotation. Okay, and I have given this particular part into what double quotation. Now I'm giving the second part, that is what my mail ID into double quotation. You must be wondering where exactly your mail ID is, what your mail ID is registered. So what you can do, now we all are aware that we are getting so many emails every day. When we are getting so many emails, what we are doing, we are actually subscribing so many things. And later on, we came to know that so many mails are coming, so many jargons are coming, and then it is really difficult to unsubscribe from each and everything. So how you will understand that where exactly Sanghvi.mahesh is actually available? So if you search this, this will give you what all your information, like you will understand that at 31 results which are there, where sangvi.mahesh@gmail.com is what available. This is one of the way of searching your research paper also. If you are using this mail ID for publishing your research paper, then naturally this mail ID will be what available into your own research paper. Normally we know that the correspondence author is having what? The correspondence author is having his mail ID available into what? Many of the research paper. What will happen when you search anything into what this double quotation, this will give you what? Information which will give you exact search, which will search only this particular information. Okay? Many times we are aware that, suppose this is my phone number, okay, my mobile number, and I have to check where exactly my mobile number is what associated. At many places, this mobile number is what associated, and you can observe that 49 results are there. Okay, so at 49 places, this mobile number, whatever I have given, is what registered. And one of them is, let's say, a very first thing is what IndiaMART, and then there is what snjb.org. Let's assume that this is my number, and this is frequent case that our mobile numbers are getting what changed. Suppose this particular mobile number is mine and it is old mobile number, and I don't want to use this mobile number further. But what I need to check, where exactly this mobile number is given on my own website. For example, our website here is what I'm giving plus sign here, means what I have given, I want to search this mobile number on our site. So for that site, we need to mention the site keyword with colon. So site colon, and then we can mention here snjb.org. This is our college website. So I'm entering that. The moment I'm entering, you will understand that one result is only found. Okay, where my mobile number is available. So what I can do with this, I can ask to my website in charge, now this mobile number is now changed and you need to change it here. And I can mention to even website coordinator where exactly this mobile number is displayed on a particular page. So you can observe here, entire path will be available. So this way we can able to identify so many things. Okay. So Google operator has great facility where we have used what exact search right now. Then we have used what site. Site operator is useful to mention whether your name is available into this particular site or not. For example, we'll just check whether my name is available into what? Into the site of what? AP Shah. So I'll just check that. Mahesh, and then what? Let's say Sangvi. Whether it is available into what? The site of AP Shah. So what I need to do? I need to check which is the site of what? AP Shah College. Okay, that I need to check first. Okay, see that this is the site, okay, which is getting open now. Okay, the moment this site will get open, what I will do? I'll simply copy this, okay, or I'll open it. And what I will do, I'll copy this site. Okay, I'll copy this site and mention here. So instead of mentioning home, I'm mentioning this and say search. And now you will understand that, now you will understand that whether my name is there or not. So my name is there, okay, but as a parent, some parent must be there, who's somewhere the name is Mahesh and somewhere the name is Sangvi, which is there, and that name is coming. So my name is not available on this particular site, but where it is available? So I can mention here about our own site, that is snjb.org, and enter, and you will understand that my name is available at this particular site. Okay, so this way you will understand that the results, quantity of results is getting decreased. And that is the reason, my dear friends, I'm telling you that this is what the session where we can, you know, able to focus more on what result. Actually, one of my friend is attending the session, Professor Birud, who is actually what heading civil department in our engineering college. We are always discussing on the part like what are the difficulties that civil engineering is facing in what searching. And by that particular discussion, I'm sharing with you my views about this so that it may be helpful to you. So this is what about what the site operator. There are some more operator that is normally needed is what, suppose I want to search about applied mechanics. So I'm giving here applied PowerPoint presentation. I want PowerPoint presentation of what applied mechanics. Okay. So what we normally do, PowerPoint presentation. Okay, and then we'll see the topic of introduction to applied mechanics. So when I'm mentioning this, okay, when I enter, what actually I'm expecting? See the results. Okay, almost the results are 7 crores 23 lakhs results are there. And now it will be our job. We are actually what planning to identify ready-made presentation. But what is happening? Who will check this 7 lakhs 23 links? Okay, instead of that, it will be easy for me to prepare my own presentation. Okay, so to reduce this, what we can do, you know, suppose we have to reduce this result and we want exact PowerPoint presentation. So you can mention here double quotation that you want introduction to what this mechanics and plus file type. We can mention here new operator, that is what file type, and then we can mention here the file type should be what PPT. Okay, so what I have given here, I have given introduction to applied mechanics into double quotation, then I have pressed what plus sign, then I am mentioning what file type. What I want file type is what PPTX. Okay, and then I'm hitting enter. Now you can observe the result which were in crores is now reduced to what 99 results, and here I can able to download the exact file whatever I want. So this way we can able to what we can able to effectively search so many things on what our Google. Okay, so that's the best part of what this. So here what we can do, you know, so you all are aware that what we can able to do. Okay, what we can able to do here, so we can simply give what search, you can give what this information and file type, likewise you can mention. So what I'm doing, I'm giving you all these operators. Okay, these notes are already available on my blog. Okay, once you are able to what search that, you can able to what do this. So what I'm doing, whatever commands I have used right now, that I'm simply copying. Okay, I'm copying it and pasting it into what our chat window, so that it will be available to you later on. So you can anytime what, okay, chat window is disabled, but anyways, what you can able to do, you know, you can able to download it from my blog here. You can see that view is there, and by using view, you can able to do that. Okay, you might have seen that somebody has what used annotation. Okay, and what I did, I have identified the person. I can take the name of that person here, but I can tell you that this may happen by mistake. And what I have done now, I have stopped. No participant can able to work out on annotation. Okay. So anyways, it's not important. So our next important part is what the next part is regarding what Gmail. So now here, these many operators you can use for what Google search. So you can, you know, you can Googling Google, you can very, very well Google your own Google effectively. Okay. So the next feature, so this much we have covered so far, that what is exactly is Google family and then Google search. And these many topics we have to deal, that Gmail and then what multiple signatures. So let's focus on what exactly is multiple signature. Now, when I'm displaying this particular part to you, you can very well aware, when I'm showing you this, you can very well aware that this way we can able to use what, this way we can able to use this. So here you can observe that this particular part is known as what signature. Okay, signature of your Gmail, and those who are actually planning for hands-on, I request you to please log in to your Gmail. Certain features are possible on mobile. Okay, and all the features are available if you are using laptop or desktop. So here you can observe that this is what, when you click on what, when you click on compose mail, okay, when you click on what compose mail, okay, it gives you what facility, it gives you facility where you will get what this particular window. And in that window, if you have what your signature, this ready-made information will come. Signature means what? The last part, which is actually what visible. Okay, so that is actually there. So here you can observe, this is known as what, if you look at this part, this is known as signature. And here some more things you will observe. Okay, some more thing you will observe, just a minute. Yeah, so I'm just hiding this window so that it will not be problematic for you. Yeah, so you can observe here one of the window, that is pane. Okay, and that is what important. When you click on this particular pain symbol, how this pain symbol will come? You need to go to compose, you need to go to signature. Okay. And here at this compose, you will get option wherever you are getting send button, you will get option. Okay, at last, that is what pain. When you click on this pain, it will show you how many signatures that you have. Okay, and based on that, you can use your any sort of signature. So I'll tell you how to add signature, and then I'll tell you how to use what multiple signature. Now, why we need multiple signature? For example, in our college, we are working on different roles. For example, I'm working as head of computer engineering department. This is one of the posts that I have mentioned here. Second post where I'm working as head of IT department. This is my second post. Now the third post, I'm acting as Dean Academics in my college. So that is my third post. Okay, so likewise, every faculty have got their own portfolio, and you're working on what different roles. So every time, if we are using only one email, we need to change what our signature every time. So instead of that, we can add three different signatures here. First signature will be of HOD computer, second signature will be of HOD IT, and third signature will be of what? Dean Academics. So likewise, you can create multiple signatures and you can use that. But question is that how to add multiple signatures or how to add signature? To add signature, when you log into your Gmail, okay, you will get option that three dots will be available to you. You will get what setting option. You have to click on that setting. Okay, and at setting, you need to select settings. Once you click on that, this dialog box will appear to you, where you have to enter at general setting, and at general setting, when you scroll down, you will get the option like signature. When you get this option like signature, you can able to add your signature. If you have not added it, okay, earlier, okay, then it will give you what facility to add it first time. If you have added or earlier, you can add multiple signatures. How to add multiple signatures? So we have option where we have to click on what this create new button. When we click on this create new button, we can able to what? We can able to add new signature. So that is the best part of what this. Now, how to do this practically, that I'll show you on what hands-on session. Okay. So suppose I have my Gmail account here, which is available. Okay. And based on this Gmail account, I'm working today. Okay. So what I need to do at very first, I need to click on compose. Okay. When I click to compose, okay, when I click to compose, you will get one of the option like signature. Already default signature is available here, and you can observe here my designation. You can observe that is what computer engineering, head of computer engineering, right? But I want to use different one. So what I need to do, you need to click here on what this insert signature, which is available by pane. Click on that pane. When you click on that pane, it will give you opportunity to what? Change your signature. And now I'm simply selecting what HOD IT. When I select HOD IT, you can observe here, the signature is now changed from head of computer engineering department to what head of IT department. And this way you can use this. There are many research scholars which are there. I have seen the website of AP Shah College where many people are pursuing their PhD. So now we are well aware that if I write this much to my guide may tell me that you are working as head. Would you like to show me this? Or you are working as research scholar. So we are actually working as what research scholar. So when we send email to our guide, it is expected that we should use any other signature. Suppose there is no signature. I have used no signature. Or we can use the signature like what research scholar. So how to add this signature, how to add this multiple signature, that I'll share with this particular hands-on session. Now what we need to do for that, for adding signature, you need to click on setting. Okay. When you click on this setting button, this mechanical gearbox will be there, right? We have to click on that. Okay. That will give you setting. Click on settings. When you enter at settings, okay, it will show you what? It will show you this general menu. We need to go to this general menu. By default, it will open general menu. And what we need to do? We need to scroll down. Okay. We need to scroll down to signature. Okay. Just scroll down. And you will get what signature available here. See that. this signature is available. Okay, and what I want to do, I want to add one more signature. So I'm creating on what? Create new. Click on create new. And what should be the name of the signature? Suppose the research scholar, I'm working as what? Research scholar. Okay, so just click, just write down research scholar, say create. Okay, and here you can write down with regards, and then you can mention here. Okay, then you can mention here Mahesh Sanghvi. Okay, then you can mention research scholar of so and so university. So you can mention here the name of what university. Okay, once you have done that, now you can anytime what changes its font, which is available here. Suppose I have changed it, I have to make it color. So I'm using a color here. So this particular part can be done easily. Okay, so I have done, and I want that this particular name should look like what? Bold. So I have done this. Okay, rest you can even insert what here, images can be inserted. You can even insert what certain links. So that is possible. For example, if somebody click on this Mahesh Sanghvi, it should open my blog. Where is that blog? This is my blog. So I'm simply copying this particular parameter. And what I'm doing here, I'm simply what clicking to this link. Click on that link, paste it here. Okay, paste it here and say, okay. When I say, okay, automatically with my name, my link will be what appear. So when we need this many times, when we have to what? We have to link our Facebook account, Twitter account, or any other social media account, we can use this option as what link. Okay, so what we have done, we have added this new signature and I'm simply saving it. Once you have done this, okay, then click on what save changes. So I'm clicking to what save changes. Once you have done with what save changes, what will happen? What will happen when I click on what compose again? Okay, I have clicked on compose and now I'm clicking to what pane. When I click on pane, you can observe here the signature which is added by me, that is research scholar, is now available here. Okay, here you can observe currently the signature which is there, default signature which is there, that is what head of computer engineering is coming. And now I wanted to write email to my PhD guide. What I will do, I will change the signature to research scholar. The moment I'm selecting that, you will observe here with regards Mahesh Sanghvi, research scholar, and whatever name of university which will be there. Okay, so here, if I click on this particular part, it will directly open. If I click on my name, it will open what? My own website. Is that clear? This way we can able to create our signature and we can able to use what this multiple signature option. So what we need to do? I'm simply repeating what we need to do for multiple signature. You need to go to compose. Okay. You need to go to compose, then check whether multiple signatures are available or not. So click on that pane. You will understand there are so many signatures which are available. Suppose you have only one signature available, you can click on even manage signature. Click on manage signature. This is the second way to enter into what your own signature page. Okay, so this will take you to what that signature page, and then you can add or remove the signature whatever you want. Okay, so how to do the signature part? See that the signature is available to me directly. And here you can go and you can change what the signatures easy. Okay, this way you can use what signature. Isn't it useful? I hope this particular part can be useful to you when you are working on what different roles. So this is all about what the first feature of what Gmail, known as Gmail signature. Okay, now look at what the different option available with Gmail is what mail snoozing. Now this is one of the wonderful operation available on mobile itself. Those who are using mobile, you can even able to use what this particular option. Now what is mail snoozing? Mail snoozing means what? You can snooze a mail for a particular period. For example, bahut sare log hai, okay, what they are facing, you know, the problem that they are facing, many emails are coming nowadays due to what this pandemic situation of what COVID-19. Okay, entire communication is going online and many emails are coming. suppose the mail of my boss is coming to me, okay, and what will happen to me, you know, like I'll give priority to that mail, okay, and when I open that mail and then the stress may come, okay. Now suppose today I'm working for my own personal task, I'm working for my PhD work, and I don't want to see the mails coming from what, from anyone. What I need to do, I need to select that mail and I'll simply say snooze. Okay, I'll show you practically how it can be done, but how to do snoozing. Okay, so that I'll show you with the help of presentation. Now you can observe here, snoozed is one of the inbox available to you. So below inbox, you will get one more option that is snoozed. So whatever mail, email that you have snoozed will enter into this particular box. Okay, this is one of the option. How to snooze the mail? When you see, when you observe any mail, you simply select that mail and at last you will get this particular icon. Okay, and this icon is looking like what? You can able to snooze that particular mail. So simply click on that. When you click on that, just a minute. When you click on what, the snooze option, what will happen, you know, you will get this particular dialog box in front of you, snooze until. Okay, when you click on snooze, it will ask you snooze until, means kab tak aap logo ko usko kya karna hai, snooze karna hai. Okay, so let's look at practically how to snooze email and what is the advantage of snooze email. Now what we need to do for snoozing, suppose this is the email, came from what, Kenjan Sangvi. Okay, I don't want to look this mail right now. What I will do, see that I have selected it, okay, and here you will get option like snooze. At last you will get what, option like snooze. Click on that. When you click on that, it is asking me when this mail should be appear to you. So I'll tell that it should, this mail should appear to me tomorrow at 8 a.m. So I'll simply click on that. What will happen, you know, see that that mail is now removed from my main inbox. ओके वो इस मेन इनबॉक्स से वो ईमेल जो भी है वो चला गया है और वो कहां जाके बैठा है अभी इट इज नाउ एंटर्ड इनटू व्हाट स्नूज्ड सो व्हेन आई क्लिक टू व्हाट द स्नूज्ड यू विल अपीयर यू विल ऑब्जर्व दिस मेल इज अवेलेबल बट व्हेन दिस मेल विल बी अपीयर टू मी ऑन इनबॉक्स अगेन दिस मेल विल बी अपीयर टू मी ऑन इनबॉक्स डायरेक्टली ऑन व्हाट डायरेक्टली व्हेन आई एंटर्ड इनटू व्हाट दिस date and time means what I have snoozed that mail I'm again snoozing it click on snooze it is asking you tomorrow at 8 a.m. so I have clicked on that this mail is now not appearing on what my main inbox but where it is available at what snoozed okay so you can observe in front of you only I have done two snoozing one is to Kenjan Sangvi's mail another one is to what Maneshwar Rajno's mail Now what will happen, this mail will be arrived to inbox automatically tomorrow at 8 a.m. So tomorrow at 8 a.m. that mail will be appearing to me and I can able to what, check it. So this is what the beauty. So certain mails can be what, hum log kuch mails jo bhi hai, wo waha par kya kar sakte hai, side mein kar sakte hai. So that's the best part of this particular option. That is what, snoozing mail. Okay, some more exciting features are available. Okay, so I'm now taking to what that particular feature. Now, after snoozing, there is one more option that is what mail scheduling. One of the best feature, okay, given by what Gmail. Now, mail scheduling means what? We can schedule our email whenever which is needed. So the way I have shown you snoozed, you can observe below inbox, you will get what scheduled email. Okay, so that schedule is actually used for that. Okay, another part, how to schedule email. So you need to click on compose. When you click on compose and would you like to send any sort of email, okay, you will see that on send option, don't click on send directly. You will get what, one arrow that may be either downside or that may be either upper side. You need to click on that arrow and you will get option schedule email. See the option which is available here. Okay, when you click on that schedule email, okay, it will, one of the dialog box will appear to you. And this dialog box will tell you when to share this email to you, whether you have to schedule this email tomorrow, whether you have to schedule this email afternoon, or whether you have to schedule this email on what, let's say Monday morning, it's up to you. Okay. And when you schedule email, that email will automatically go on that particular day. Now, when we need this type of feature, for example, my boss have demanded some information from me and he has demanded that information. Let's say I want this data on what, coming Monday. Okay, and suppose that coming Monday is one of the day. Now, nowadays, it is really challenging to remember everything. हमारे पास सारा रेडी होने के बावजूद भी हम लोग भूल जाते हैं उसको भेजना. ओके, क्योंकि हम लोगों को भी मंडे मॉर्निंग में याद आना चाहिए. सो व्हाट वी कैन डू, वी कैन क्रिएट ईमेल, राइट दैट ईमेल कंप्लीटली. ओके, एंड शेयर इट ऑन व्हाट एंड यूज व्हाट शेड्यूल ऑप्शन. व्हेन यू यूज दिस शेड्यूल ऑप्शन विल व्हाट मेक इट वेरी सिंपल. योर लाइफ विल बी व्हाट वेरी सिंपल विद द हेल्प ऑफ व्हाट दिस शेड्यूल ऑप्शन. ओके, सो व्हेन यू क्लिक ऑन दिस शेड्यूल ऑप्शन, द मोमेंट यू आर शेड्यूलिंग, what I will do, I'll schedule it on what? Monday. So I'll click what on this schedule option. I'll say Monday 8 a.m. that mail should go. And my boss will be very happy without any sort of what feedback, without any follow-up. You have what sent that mail at 8 a.m. Okay. So schedule option will help you for that. Okay. Now how to work with the schedule option? So I'll show you what, I'll show you the hands-on of it. What I need to do, click on compose. Click on compose, and suppose I wanted to send, okay, suppose there is what a madam, okay, who is actually what communicating me all the information till date. Okay, so what I'm doing, see that her mail is with me, her mail ID is with me, so I'm using that mail ID, and I wanted to give her what, I wanted to give her feedback of this particular session, or suppose I have to give thanks to her. What I will do, I'll simply write compose her mail ID. I'll take, okay, thanks for the opportunity. Okay, and here I can mention, dear ma'am, special thanks to you and your team. Okay, your team for the opportunity to put forth my views about googling Google in one of the leading FDP arranged by you. For example, this is what I wanted to send. What I will do for this, okay, I have written everything here. Okay, I have written, but currently, I'm conducting this session. I don't want to finish it immediately. It's not good to send it immediately. What I will do, I'll simply schedule it. I'll click on this down arrow. I'll click on schedule send. Now it will ask me when to send this. I'll pick up the use pick and date. Okay. And I want to send it today only. But at what time I want to send? Suppose my session will end at 12 p.m. Okay. So what I'm doing at 12:15 p.m., I'm what selecting it. And simply say schedule send. So automatically this email will move to what? See that it is coming under what schedule? You can observe here. Okay, this mail, the moment I'm opening, you will observe here, this mail is scheduled at what? 12:15 p.m. So automatically at 12:15 p.m. this mail will what? Move to the concerned person, okay, whose mail ID I have given here. Okay, so likewise, many people are demanding from admin that please share what this feedback or attendance sheet to everyone. So what we can do here, we can always use the scheduling option where you will get what at 11:30 or at 11:45, you will get an email, okay, having what, having that link of what feedback. You can schedule your email like that also. So this is what we can use, what schedule option. Okay, now move towards the next option. One of the important options for the teachers and many of the faculty members, right? That is what Gmail confidential mail. Now sending confidential mail is very important. In India, the word confidential is used very confidentially. When we say anyone, कि दिस इज वेरी कॉन्फिडेंशियल इन्फॉर्मेशन, ओके, किसी को बताना मत, तो हमारे यहाँ पर नॉर्मली क्या होता है, जब कॉन्फिडेंशियल यदि बोला तो मुझे तो ऐसे लगता है कि कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी को पब्लिसिटी की जरूरत ही नहीं है. यानी मैं यदि आप लोगों को यहाँ पर बता दूं कि हमारे यहाँ पर आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस और डेटा साइंस का कोर्स SNJB में स्टार्ट हुआ है इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज में एज अ नया ब्रांच, किसी को बताना मत. यदि ऐसा मैं किसी को बोलता हूँ तो वो हर जगह पे उसको क्या कर देगा, बता देगा, तो कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी को आज की डेट में पब्लिसिटी की जरूरत नहीं पड़ती है, ऑटोमेटिकली लोग उसको क्या करते हैं, शेयर करते हैं। बट माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, यहां पर व्हेन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस जीमेल कॉन्फिडेंशियल मेल, मेनी टाइम्स यू आर वर्किंग एज व्हाट, पेपर सेटर, क्वेश्चन पेपर, इफ यू आर सेटिंग एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ क्वेश्चन पेपर एंड यू वॉन्ट टू सेंड दैट कॉन्फिडेंशियल मेल टू योर चेयरमैन, यू कैन यूज दिस ऑप्शन, दैट इज व्हाट कॉन्फिडेंशियल मेल। Now, the benefit of this confidential mail is that when you click on this compose, okay, it will give you facility, okay, where you can write down your entire mail and you will get what, one of the option here, okay, wherever you will get what, my mouse pointer, you can see that that option is available. Click on that, turn confidential mode on. So, आप लोगों को एक lock और घड़ी का symbol दिखाई देगा. One lock and one watch is there. Okay, you have to click on that symbol. When you click on that symbol, okay, what will happen? Okay, this particular dialog box will come in front of you. Okay, and here you can choose whenever you want to send. अब आप सभी लोगों को ये पता होगा कि when I send you any sort of email, एक बार आपके inbox में वो चीज आ गई तो मुझे आपके inbox का control नहीं है. I cannot remove your email. Okay, मैं आपके inbox में जाके मेरा जो email आया है उसको मैं remove नहीं कर सकता हूँ. Okay, that facility is not available. लेकिन हमारे पास दूसरा ऑप्शन क्या है, यदि मुझे लगता है कि whenever I am sending you any sort of email, okay, and that email should expire on so and so date, यानी दो दिन के बाद आपको जो ईमेल मैंने भेजा हुआ है वो ऑटोमेटिकली आपके इनबॉक्स में से क्या होना चाहिए, डिलीट होना चाहिए, then you can use here set expiration and here you can use that expire in on which date you would like to what ये ईमेल जो भी ये एक्सपायर होना चाहिए, तो ऑटोमेटिकली जब आप ये वाला डेट यहाँ पर सेट कर दोगे, ऑटोमेटिकली उस डेट पर वो जो भी मेल रहेगा आपके फ्रेंड के मेल इनबॉक्स से क्या हो जाएगा, डिलीट हो जाएगा। देयर इज वन मोर ऑप्शन। बहुत बार क्या होता है कि काफी बार ऐसे होता है कि हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट जब छुट्टी पे होते हैं या कहीं पे उनको कहीं लॉन्ग लीव पे जाना रहता है तो वो क्या करते हैं, उनका जीमेल का एक्सेस कोई नेक्स्ट पर्सन को दे देते हैं। जब नेक्स्ट पर्सन को जीमेल का एक्सेस दिया है और मैं उनके अंडर काम कर रहा हूँ, दोनों के अंडर मैं काम कर रहा हूँ, मुझे जो भी मेल भेजना है वो मेन हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट जो है उसी ने देखना चाहिए, जो इंचार्ज है उसने नहीं देखना चाहिए। तो अब क्या होगा, मेन हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट ने यदि इंचार्ज के पास वो ईमेल का यूजर आईडी और पासवर्ड दिया है तो उसको तो सभी दिखाई देगा। उस केस में यू कैन यूज व्हाट, पासकोड ऑप्शन। जब आप एसएमएस पासकोड का यूज करोगे तो यहाँ पर क्या होगा, वो ईमेल उस बंदे को दिखाई तो देगा लेकिन वो पढ़ नहीं पाएगा, इंचार्ज उसको पढ़ नहीं पाएगा, और पासकोड जो है वो उसको क्या बोलेगा, सेंड इट टू पर्टिकुलर मोबाइल नंबर, और वो मोबाइल नंबर किसका रहेगा, आपके हेड का। सो यहाँ पर कॉन्फिडेंशियल मेल का यूज आप जब भी करोगे तो ये आपको क्या कर देगा, ये रेस्ट्रिक्ट कर देगा आपको कौन सी चीजों के लिए, ये वाला मेल जो है ये सामने वाला बंदा जो है ना उसको फॉरवर्ड कर पाएगा, ना उसको डाउनलोड कर पाएगा, ना उसको कॉपी कर पाएगा, ना उसको कहीं पे कोई प्रिंट कर पाएगा। ओके, सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट ऑप्शन। लेट्स लुक एट दिस पर्टिकुलर ऑप्शन ओके प्रैक्टिकली सो दैट यू विल अंडरस्टैंड द मेन यूज ऑफ इट। ओके, सो आई विल शो यू दिस पर्टिकुलर पार्ट प्रैक्टिकली। नाउ व्हाट वी नीड टू डू फॉर दिस, यू नीड टू क्लिक ऑन व्हाट, कंपोज। ओके, नीड टू क्लिक ऑन कंपोज। I have to send this mail to my head of computer engineering department. So I have selected his mail ID. Okay. And I'll say here the feedback of session. Okay. Feedback of session. Suppose I have written this particular mail. Okay. Means I have given the subject line, that is feedback of session. And here I'm mentioning that, dear sir, the today's session was so and so, okay, that I have mentioned. Now it's up to you whether it was good or bad, right? You can mention that. And my suggestions for the next session, suppose I'm mentioning this next session, okay, and I can mention what the next session details here. Now what will happen, I don't want to show this particular part to anyone because this is highly confidential mail that I want to send. What I need to do, I have written this mail, what I need to do, I need to make it confidential. So click on this particular symbol. Okay, which symbol you need to click? You need to click on this lock and watch symbol. Click on that. The moment you are clicking on that, it will show you what, when this particular mail should get expired. ओके, मेरा एम क्या है, मेरे हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट को ये फीडबैक दिखना चाहिए और थोड़ी देर के बाद ये वाला फीडबैक जो भी वो रिमूव होना चाहिए। ओके, कल ये वाला फीडबैक रिमूव होना चाहिए। सो व्हाट आई विल डू, क्लिक हियर, ओके, से दैट एक्सपायर इन वन डे, सो आई एम सिलेक्टिंग दिस। Okay, so automatically this mail will expire on what? 24th June 2020. Okay, and I have to mention what passcode here. Okay, why to send passcode? So that if this mail ID is used by any other in charge, unless and until that in charge has passcode, cannot able to open this mail. So I'm setting that passcode and say save. The moment I'm saying save, okay, as my mobile number is already saved here, so it is not asking me anything. But if your mobile number is not saved, it will ask you what mobile number as well. Now what will happen? You can observe here, certain contents are visible. Content expire on what? June 24, 2020, and recipient can't able to what? Forward, copy, print and download this particular email. And this way you can send what? Confidential mail. Once you have done, say what? Send. Click on send. Now it is asking me, see that mobile number. Now I'm mentioning the mobile number here, 9, whatever mobile number that I have, I'm mentioning that. Okay, and say send. You need to mention the mobile number of what? The recipient. That I have done and I have sent that mail. And now I'm checking whether this mail is available to me or not. I'll say refresh. This is mail of head of the department and that I'm observing. Okay. The mail sent by what? Sangvi.mr should be available here, right? Okay, yet the mail has not received. I'll again say what? Refresh. See that this mail is now appeared. Okay, Mahesh Sangvi, SNJB, this mail is appeared. Feedback of the session means what? Subject line is visible. Now I'm clicking to that. I'm opening that mail. When I'm opening this mail at receiver's end, okay, what will happen, you know, I cannot able to see the contents. The contents are not visible. And trust me, this is known as what? Confidential mail. Unless and until I use this passcode, it will not show me what that. So what I'm doing now, I'm using passcode, send passcode. Okay, now it is asking me for the passcode. Now I'm checking with the passcode. Passcode is received to me and I'm mentioning that. Okay, so I have mentioned my passcode here and then I'm submitting it. Upon submission of this passcode, okay, see that I can able to see this mail now. Okay, I can able to see this mail. Now this mail is visible to me. Is that clear? Okay, so passcode will give you what that facility. Another part, check. Suppose I want to send this mail to somebody else. I want to forward this mail. That option will not be available here. You cannot forward, you cannot copy, even you cannot print. Suppose I want to take the print. I'm using Control P option. Okay, it will not allow me to what? Print this particular mail to. Okay, so this way you can use what? This option, that is what? Confidential mail. How to use this confidential mail access? I'm just repeating that. Go to compose, write down your entire mail, then click on what? This option, that is what? Confidential mail appearing here just besides your pane. Click on that. Set what? When that particular mail should get expired. Automatically that mail will expire from what? Recipient inbox. One of the best feature. Okay, and if you want to use what? Passcode, click on what? SMS passcode. Okay, this both the features can be used to send what? Confidential mail. So this is all about what? Confidential mail. Now I'm coming towards what? The last part of this particular session, and that is ultimately what? Filtering. Okay, how to filter your email. Now this is one of the fabulous option and needed every time. You must be fed up of so many emails. Many emails are coming to you every day because we have subscribed to so many free packages. When we download any free packages, they are asking us to what? Subscribe first. And we don't have any option left. We need to subscribe. And after subscription, you are observing that so many mails are coming and it is really difficult to identify what the actual mail. So what this filtering will tell you? You need to click on what? This search button, okay, which is available here, okay. When you click on that, this particular dialog box will appear to you. Okay, write down whatever you want to search. Okay, and click on what? This create filter button. When you click on this create filter button, okay, then this dialog box will appear to you and this will tell you what option you want to take. कई बार आपको जो भी ईमेल आते हैं, आपको यदि लगता है कि वो ईमेल ऑटोमेटिकली आपको क्या करना है, रीड मार्क करना है, यू कैन सिंपली सिलेक्ट दिस चेक मार्क इट. व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेनेवर दैट मेल विल कम फ्रॉम दैट पर्सन, ऑटोमेटिकली इट विल मार्क एज व्हाट रीड. यदि आपको लगा कि कुछ मेल जो भी है आपके बॉस से आ रहा है, उसको आपको इंपॉर्टेंट मेल है, आप उसको स्टार मार्क कर सकते हैं. आपको यदि लगा कि कुछ मेल ये काम का ही नहीं है, बिना पढ़े आपको उसको डिलीट करना है, यू कैन यूज व्हाट दिस डिलीट ऑप्शन. ओके, सो आई विल शेयर यू हाउ दिस कैन बी डन. Okay, so how this can be done? So I'll just share you practically. See that this is my inbox. Okay, this is my inbox. Here I'm mentioning that any mail coming from sangvi.mahesh, this is my mail ID that I have mentioned. Any mail coming from sangvi.mahesh should be automatically deleted. Okay, it should get deleted automatically, or it should get what? Important star mark automatically. What will happen? आपको क्या करना रहेगा, सिंपली यहां पर ईमेल आईडी देना है. ओके, गो टू क्रिएट फिल्टर एंड सिंपली से स्टार इट. ओके, सिंपली से व्हाट? स्टार इट. अब जैसे ही स्टार इट बोलोगे, ओके, तो क्या होगा, ऑटोमेटिकली उस मेल को जब भी वो आएगा स्टार मार्क कर देगा. मैंने फिल्टर क्रिएट कर दिया, क्लिक ऑन क्रिएट फिल्टर. ओके, अब क्या हो रहा है, मैं यहां से मेल भेज रहा हूं sangvi.mahesh से. ओके, आई एम सिंपली सेंडिंग व्हाट ईमेल टू हूम, दैट मेल आईडी दैट इज sangvi.mr. ओके, टेस्ट मेल फॉर फिल्टर. फिल्टर के लिए ये टेस्ट मेल है. हेलो, थैंक्स. सपोज आई एम सेंडिंग दिस मेल. ओके, वंस आई क्लिक ऑन सेंड, सी दैट व्हाट विल हैपन हियर. The moment I say refresh, what will happen? The moment that mail comes, it will mark it as important mail. It will mark it as what? Star. Okay, so let's look at that. Yet it is not received. Okay, I'll say again refresh. See that this mail is coming and automatically they have marked what? Star here. Okay, so this way you can able to use filter option, one of the fabulous to make your mail effectively. Okay, if you have to read the things effectively, what you will do, you can use this filter option. Where it is available, मैं एक बार फिर से आपको बताता हूँ कि मुझे अभी ये Bitly वाला जो भी mail आया है ना, okay, ये मुझे सारे remove करने हैं. अब देखिए मैं क्या कर रहा हूँ, यहाँ पर bitly.com से जितने भी मेल्स आए हैं वो मुझे चाहिए. ओके, हम कैसे सर्च करेंगे, हाउ विल वी सर्च? मैंने इसको कॉपी किया, यहां पर मैंने बोला, ओके, यहां पर मैंने सर्च किया और एंटर दिया. जैसे मैं एंटर दे रहा हूं, आप देखिए बहुत सारे मेल्स यहां पर अवेलेबल है. मुझे हर एक मेल को क्या करना पड़ेगा, सिलेक्ट करना पड़ेगा, डिलीट करना पड़ेगा. ये तो मैं पिछले मेल के लिए कर दूंगा, लेकिन और कोई नया मेल आया तो बिटली का, वो भी ऑटोमेटिकली क्या होना चाहिए, डिलीट होना चाहिए. तो मैं उसको क्या कर सकता हूँ, यहां पर जा रहा हूं, फिल्टर के लिए जा रहा हूं, गो टू फिल्टर. ओके, यहां पर आपको क्या देना रहेगा, bitly.com जो भी है वो देना रहेगा. मैं फिर से बता रहा हूं आपको, यहां जाना है, bitly.com के लिए जाना है. ओके, गो टू क्रिएट फिल्टर, इंस्टेड ऑफ सर्च गो फॉर क्रिएट फिल्टर. क्रिएट फिल्टर विल आस्क यू टू गो फॉर एक्शन. क्या करना है, इसको ऑटोमेटिकली डिलीट करना है. सो वेन एवर बिटली विल कम, इट शुड डिलीट ऑटोमेटिकली. ओके, और यदि लगता है, आप देखिए यहां पर एक लास्ट का जो ऑप्शन है, ये आपको ये बता रहा है कि 11 ईमेल्स वैसे है, वो मैच कर रहा है, उसके लिए भी करना है क्या? ये वाला ऑप्शन क्या बोलता है आपको, आने वाले ईमेल के साथ में करना है, अभी पहले से जो है उनके साथ में कुछ नहीं करना है. लेकिन मुझे लगता है कि पहले भी जो थे उनके साथ में भी मुझे उसको रिमूव करना है, यूज लास्ट ऑप्शन ऑल्सो. सो व्हाट आई हैव डन, आई हैव सिलेक्टेड डिलीटेड, आई हैव सिलेक्टेड दिस एंड सिंपली से क्रिएट फिल्टर. सी दैट दिस ईमेल व्हाटएवर व्हिच इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू विल गेट डिलीटेड इजी. See that it is removed. No mail ID will be there. No mails from what Bitly will be there. Now, whenever Bitly का mail जैसे ही आएगा, automatically ये कहाँ पर चला जाएगा? मेरे trash में जाके पड़ेगा. आपको यदि उसको check ही करना है, आपको कहाँ जाना पड़ेगा? आपको bin या trash नाम का folder होता है. You need to go to that trash folder. See that it is available. Click there. Okay. click there and you can see here, see all the mails related to Bitly are available here. Okay, and you can simply use what empty trash option. I'm using it, empty trash. So I'm simply removing everything. I don't want this trash, this mail IDs, these emails. So I've removed it permanently. Okay, so this way you can use this particular option. Okay, so now I request that to administrator, how much time I have for my session? Can anyone please tell me?
Sir, you have next 10 minutes, sir.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. So in next 10 minutes, I'll show you one more option, one of the fabulous option, that is what Google Calendar. This is now needed highly. Now, if you observe, there are so many things that we need to remember. As a head of department, what we need to do, entire academic calendar should be entered into what Google Calendar. Okay, kahi baar hum logo ko aisa hota hai ki month end pe kuch kaam karne rehte hai. Suppose at month end, if head of the department or dean academics or academic in charge wish to collect syllabus completion report from all the faculties. Okay, so that person has to remember on 25th of every month, I need to send email to everyone ki aapko kya karna hai, syllabus completion report jo bhi hai wo dena hai. So instead of that, we can use what Google Calendar, and Google Calendar will work. It will what? It will take care of you every time, and you can able to create the calendar easily. How to do that for Google Calendar? You need to log into your Gmail. When you go for Gmail, you need to click on this 9 dots. Okay. You need to click on this 9 dots. Okay. Once you click on that nine dots, this dialog box will appear to you and select simply on what calendar. Once you select on calendar, this will be in front of you. Okay. So this will show you what calendar entry, where the entry from Sunday to Saturday will be available here. Date will be appear to me. Okay. And entire calendar will be what in front of you. So now it's up to you. You can able to create your own event. What I need to do? Click on this create. Aapko create par click karna padega. Create ke upar aapko click karna hai simply. When you click on create, aapke samne ye wala dialog box aayega. जब ये वाला डायलॉग बॉक्स आपके सामने आएगा, व्हाट यू नीड टू डू, यू नीड टू एंटर द टाइटल ऑफ इवेंट. सपोज देयर इज मीटिंग शेड्यूल्ड बाय योर हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट और योर बॉस, व्हाट यू नीड टू डू, यू नीड टू मेंशन द टाइटल हियर एंड सिंपली शेड्यूल दैट मीटिंग. ओके, यू कैन ऐड व्हाट गेस्ट हियर, दैट आई विल शो यू. ओके, दिस इज व्हाट दिस पर्टिकुलर बॉक्स विल कम अप व्हेन यू क्लिक ऑन व्हाट मोर ऑप्शन. व्हेन यू क्लिक ऑन मोर ऑप्शन, दिस विल कम. ओके, वेयर यू कैन मेंशन द टाइटल. सपोज आई हैव गिवन द टाइटल इटसेल्फ इज व्हाट गूगलिंग गूगल. Okay, and then I have mentioned the date May 26, जब ये मेरा session first time कहीं पे हुआ था. So उस time पे मैंने ये snapshot लिए है. I'll show you the new entry also. Okay, and here you can mention everything, that location, then notification. Yeah, this is one of the fabulous option. ये notification option क्या करेगा? यहाँ पे आपको दो option मिलते हैं. जब आप notification कहोगे और 10 minutes before बोलोगे तो क्या होगा? ऑटोमेटिकली आपकी मोबाइल में ये वाला रिमाइंडर जो भी वो सेट होगा, आपके गूगल, आपका जो भी कैलेंडर है मोबाइल का, उसमें जाके ये वाला इवेंट सेट हो जाएगा एंड इट विल रिमाइंड यू बिफोर 10 मिनट्स ऑन मोबाइल. दिस इज वन पार्ट. इफ यू क्लिक ऑन ऐड नोटिफिकेशन, वन मोर ऑप्शन विल अपीयर. इंस्टेड ऑफ नोटिफिकेशन, ईमेल ऑप्शन विल अपीयर. इफ यू क्लिक ऑन ईमेल एंड इफ यू अगेन सेट टू 10 मिनट्स, इट विल शो यू दैट पर्टिकुलर पार्ट ऑल्सो. Okay, so notification will tell you that 10 minutes before 10 minutes reminder will come on your mobile, and another part before 10 minutes you will get what reminder on your email also. Okay, so these are two parts. Another part, you can color the thing if you want that this should be made blue or red, it's up to you. And then you can put your matter and you can add the guest, means who is actually participating in the event. Okay, so I'll simply show you this particular part. Okay, so what we need to do, we need to go to Gmail. Okay, click on this 9 dots, click on calendar, and suppose in this calendar, what I need to do, I need to create one of the event. जैसे मैंने अभी आप लोगों को बताया था कि I need to what, मुझे सभी लोगों से क्या लेना है, syllabus completion report लेना है every month on 25th. ओके, सो व्हाट आई नीड टू डू, देखिए आपने गूगलिंग गूगल का जो सेशन था ना मुंबई का, ये वाला आज का, ये भी मैंने यहाँ पर मार्क करके रखा था, तो इसने मुझे ऑटोमेटिकली क्या किया, रिमाइंड कर दिया. ओके, सो व्हाट आई एम डूइंग नाउ, आई एम क्रिएटिंग अ सेशन. क्रिएट. ओके, क्रिएट. नाउ दिस डायलॉग बॉक्स विल अपीयर टू मी. आई सिलेक्ट मोर ऑप्शन एंड नाउ आई एम राइटिंग हियर सिलेबस completion, repo. Okay, now I'm mentioning here when I want this. So click on that. I want it on 25th. Okay, would you like to repeat this? Yes, I want to repeat this. Okay, monthly on last Saturday or Thursday, or monthly on that particular day. So I'm using what? Let's say I'm using this particular option. So every last Thursday on that particular month, this information will appear to whom? So many people. Kaha par dena hai ye syllabus completion report? Online using Google spreadsheet. Okay, so I have mentioned that. Okay, here notification will appear. I'm setting this means before 10 minutes this will appear. I can add one more notification. Click on that. Instead of notification, I'm taking email. So before this notification will come on your mobile and email will come on your email. This way you can do. And I'm choosing the color, let's say red. Okay, I have chosen the color like what? Red. And here you can mention the link for syllabus completion is. यानी मैं ये चाहता हूँ कि लोगों ने इस लिंक के ऊपर क्लिक करना है, ओके, और इस लिंक के ऊपर जैसे ही वो क्लिक करेंगे, they will get what syllabus completion report where they have to mention. किसको भेजना है ये? तो मैं अपना जो और एक दूसरा मेल आईडी है, उसको मैं ये भेजना चाहता हूँ, so I'm using that. Okay, I want to send to one more mail ID, suppose hud.com. So I have used that. So जितने भी mail IDs को आप send करना चाहोगे, वो यहाँ पे आपको simply क्या करना है? Select करना है and say save. जैसे ही आप सेव बोलोगे, ये आपको बोल रहा है कि उनको दिखना चाहिए क्या ये मेल जो भी है, वो इनविटेशन जाना चाहिए क्या? यदि आपको लगता है यस, गो सेंड, क्लिक ऑन सेंड. ओके, नाउ इट इज आस्किंग मी बिकॉज इट इज ऑफ snjp.org, सो इट इज आस्किंग मी कि जीमेल के लिए भेजना है क्या. आई सेड यस. ओके, वंस आई हैव डन दिस, यू विल सी दैट दिस रेड कलर. ओके, दिस इज द सिलेबस कंप्लीशन रिपोर्ट विच इज एडेड एवरी थर्सडे of what any month. So if I go to any of the next month, okay, if you even go to what next month, you will see that this will appear to everyone. Okay, and automatically on that day before 10 minutes of 12 p.m. it will remind all the faculty members that I have added. Now see, you will see this particular mail which may be available here. See that this invitation is available here. Okay, I'm opening that. When I open this, it is telling me, would you like to join this event? आपको इसमें participate करना है क्या? You can say yes. Okay, जिससे ये पता चल जाएगा recipient को, जिसने ये भेजा हुआ था, उसको ये पता चल जाएगा कि आपने इसको yes बोला है और आप इसमें participate करने वाले हैं. तो automatically आपके mail, आपका जो भी means ये वाला जो भी है, यहाँ पर भी मैं क्या कर रहा हूँ, उसके calendar में जाऊँगा. When I click to this calendar, okay, this is the calendar that I'm opening up. What? दूसरे मेल आईडी के ऊपर मैं जाके ये कर रहा हूँ जहां पे मैंने इसको भेजा हुआ है. सो व्हेन आई एम यूजिंग दैट, व्हाट इट विल डू, यू नो, इट विल इवन शो मी द एंट्री ऑफ 25th ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर सिलेबस कंप्लीशन. ओके, सो मैं अभी 25th के ऊपर क्लिक कर देता हूँ.
हेलो,
यस मैम.
महेश सर, सॉरी, रियली सॉरी टू इंटरप्ट, बट वी आर रनिंग शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम.
यस सर,
you may just proceed for the next 5 minutes please.
Yes, within 5 minutes I am finishing now.
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Yeah, see that you will appear here this syllabus completion report. So I'm clicking on that. Okay, and you will see that this is now available and I can use this link. If I use this link, I can able to what, add my data here. So at every month last Thursday this particular mail will remind you. Okay, and this is the use of what, this calendar. Now you can observe this many entries that I have on my Google calendar. See, and different colors I'm using. Okay, at this particular right left corner you will see Mahesh Sanghvi, and so many entries are available of what, my Google calendar. And trust me, this Google calendar is actually, if you are using it effectively, it will definitely give you what, great thing. Okay, so this is all about from my end. I'm really thankful to what everyone, okay, for attending, for patience listening, okay, for this particular session. Okay, and if you have any questions or any queries, you can write it on what, your chat box, or you can ask me directly.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you so much, sir. We actually, the questions have already started pouring. We have received a few questions from the participants. Shall I put forward one by one?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so first question is, how can we change schedule of email?
Yeah, that's a great question. So what you need to do when you have to, suppose you have scheduled any sort of email, okay? And just a minute. Yeah, so what you need to do when you are entering into your Gmail, okay, you will get what this scheduled mail. I have scheduled one email here. So click on that schedule. Click on that schedule, open that mail again and say here cancel first. You can cancel this mail here. Okay, you can cancel this mail here, and again you need to what? Reschedule that mail. So there is only option that you cannot change it, you cannot modify it, but what you need to do, you need to remove the earlier one and need to set one more email. Okay, hope I have given the answer of your query.
I hope it will be clear to the participant. Another question is by Ms. Sheetal Karale. How can we mail all members of group in one click as we do in WhatsApp?
Okay, so for that, there are options. Okay, what we need to do when we create anything here, okay, we have option that we need to create either Google groups. Okay, the way we are creating WhatsApp group, we can create what Google groups. In that we can add all the email IDs. This is one way. Another way, you can create mailing list. Okay, you can create mailing list. In that mailing list, you can add all the email IDs and all, and then at a stroke, you can send that mail. For example, we have certain groups. For example, I have group of faculty of what computer engineering. Suppose this is the group. The moment I'm using this group, here I'm using the options like what? Google groups.com. We have created this group, and automatically whatever I want to send will be sent to this particular group. Means there are almost 40 emails available under this group. Automatically 40 mails will go to what? That 40 members. Right?
Right.
So, yeah. Next question, please.
Another question is, how can we tag batches to signature?
Sorry, batches?
Yes, how can we tag batches to signature?
Sorry, I'm not getting the question.
Achha,
batches
okay.
Means?
Maybe we are talking about the student batches.
Student batches, in that case, I don't know actually how it will be related to what signature. Signature is all about when you are sending any information or any email, at last, whatever which is appearing is your signature. Okay, and if you are thinking that your signature is different for certain groups, you can create multiple signature and simply change that signature using the option which is given as a pane here. Suppose here you can change the signature option by simply clicking on this pane, and it will display you what this many signatures here. If you're talking about different batch, you can create signature for different batches here and simply select that batch, and automatically it will appear. Suppose I'm selecting my personal. See that only this much, my name is only appeared and my photograph is appearing here. Okay, rest part is what I did. So this way you can use what multiple signature. I don't know whether I have solved your doubt or not.
Okay, maybe I hope the participant is clear. Otherwise they may ask again in the chat box.
Right.
Another question is, if the document we send the person can't copy or download or print the mail, how will that be helpful? It's further is, we as professors need to send mark sheets or even question papers that are to be printed, but at the same time we want it to be confidential. Is that possible? The person can download and print it in spite of being confidential. That will be really helpful for the academicians.
Right. This is really wonderful question, and thanks to the participant who asked this particular question. Okay, first of all, let me clear one particular part. When we are sending confidential email, when you are uploading any file, attaching any file, that file will be sent to the person. That person can able to open that file, but can't be downloaded. That file will open. That file will be visible to that person, but he or she cannot able to download that. So whenever you are attaching any document, it can be downloaded. It can be only opened. It will not get downloaded on your local machine. This is first part. Okay. Second part. Now, this is what the free feature given by what? confidential mail facility. This is the free feature given by Gmail, and currently Gmail is only giving you facility of what restricting everything. If you want to enable downloading option, you need to register for G Suite, okay? And when you purchase this G Suite account, probably you need what, 500 rupees per year. That subscription cost will be needed to you, and then they will open that option to you that you can give them option to forward or just to download or just to print. So that things are only available with what, paid option. Unfortunately, it is not available into what, this free option. Hope I solve your purpose.
Yeah, sir, that was really helpful.
Yes, ma'am.
When we were talking about that batch question, now we are getting the query like it's about like AutoCAD batch or any professional badges they are talking about.
Batches, I'm still not getting the batch actually. Can you please explore, or the person having doubt can explore please, what do they mean?
They mean how to add badges to signature like AutoCAD badge or any professional badges. I request the participant if they can, elaborate it so that it's clear for the speaker.
Yeah, because I'm not getting the meaning of batch.
Okay. So last question.
Yes, ma'am.
How can we recover deleted mails?
How to recover deleted mail?
Deleted mails.
Yeah. So suppose I have email, okay, which is there. For example, this is the mail available with me. Okay. And I want to delete this mail. What we do, we normally select and remove this mail. Okay, this is the mail that is what accepted syllabus completion report. I'm deleting this. When I delete this mail normally go to what, trash. Okay, it go to what, trash. And at many places, if you are using mobile, then you will get the option like bin. Okay, trash or bin. You need to search below inbox, you need to go down. You will get, on mobile, you will get option like bin. And on your laptop or desktop, you will get option like trash. Click on that trash. You will appear this particular mail. Click on this mail. And you want to what? If you want to remove this mail forever, you can simply say remove. Or you can recover this particular mail again. Okay, so this is the way of what, doing this. This way you can able to what? Open this mail also, you can read this mail, and even you can even recover this particular mail again. So this is the use of this particular facility. Where you need to do, I'm just repeating, you need to go at trash, that mail will appear to you. Once this mail is appeared to you, what you can do here, you can simply say that you can simply recover this particular mail, and this mail will be what appearing to your inbox. So where you need to go at this. But if you remove this mail from this, then probably Google will help you to recover this, okay? But once you remove from what, trash or bin, then trust me, you need to take the help of Google only, and they can only what, help you. But trust me, simply I'll tell you that you cannot recover the mail if you go at what, that particular label, okay? So this is all about that.
Yeah, we have another question from Mihir Chandra. How to record Google Class?
Google Class?
Class.
How to record?
How to record Google Class?
Sorry, I'm not again getting this question. Google Class means you are talking about Google Classroom or what?
Yeah, they may be talking about Google Class.
Okay, so for Google Classroom, actually, we have not covered this particular part here in this, but when I open Google Classroom, we need to open this. Okay, it is again available the way we have opened what, calendar. We need to go at that part, open that Google Classroom. One of the fabulous feature nowadays highly needed if you want to take what, assignment of the students, or if you would like to take what, online examinations or offline examination, you should set up what, Google Classroom. So this many Google Classroom that I have set up for my students, I can open any Google Classroom for you. Suppose I'm opening this. Okay, how to recover class is what is happening, you know, when I'm talking about this, okay. We cannot, first of all, there is no facility to delete what, any of the classroom. Okay, it can be, wo kaha par hota hai, wo archive hote hai. Aur archive jo hote hai, aapko archive jo kiye gaye hai, wo aapko yaha pe archive classes karke dikhai deta hai. So when I click on archive classes, dekhiye, do classes maine banaye the, ek test wala aur ek ye wala. To ye wale classes yaha par aa gaye hai. what I need to do, I need to simply what? I need to simply move it again to what my normal classes. Okay, when I move, automatically it will appear to what an RQ classes. So this way we can able to what? We can able to get our classes again if it is what deleted. Normally it is not deleted, it is normally what acute. So you can get what all this acute by this way. Hope I serve the purpose. Hope
okay, I solve your feature of Google is really great.
Yeah, Google Classroom is one of the fabulous feature, and even many of the UGC circular have mentioned nowadays that take the assignment from the students either from what learning management tools like Moodle, or parallelly you can use what Google Classroom.
Absolutely.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Participant Dinesh Jaljula and Bharat Pulwari raise their hands. Umesh sir, can you please unmute them so that they can ask their question? Hello.
Yes.
Umesh sir? No, I'm actually talking to my technical team in charge.
Madam, their names are not there in the list. No.
Okay, okay, fine. They may have left. Okay, sir. So as we are running short of time, so we'll end the question and answer session here only. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you very much for such a wonderful and really useful session for all the participants, irrespective of whether he or she is an academician, research scholar, or industrial. Now we realize that till date we were using only a fraction of Google features. You have shown us the hidden treasures of Google, and I'm sure all the participants will now be able to use Google more efficiently. Thank you so much. Thank you once again for joining us. We are really grateful to you.
Thank you so much. Thanks to everyone, all the participants, as well as what organizer for giving me this opportunity to put forth my views. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Yes.